Hi guys, welcome to Puerto Viejo, Costa Rica. I've been here about 5 days now, so I'm gonna catch you up on where I last left off. I was last in Pavones. The last day there was good. One thing I forgot to leave, or I left out, was the last day we surfed, I think, all together in Saleas. I was teaching one of the girls a little bit how to surf, who's new. And I tried her longboard at the end because I had been riding a shortboard the whole time. So she had like a 9 foot. So it was cool getting to try with a longboard. It was a completely different experience. And then after getting used to riding a shortboard for so long, it was really weird going back to it. But I was able to catch some longer waves. So that was nice. And then that last night was really cool because the neighbor next door, the guy living there, he's from Monterey, California, but he lives there like half a year or something, I kind of forget. But he was a sushi chef, basically. So it was really nice that he ended up like making all this sushi and sharing it with us. Anyways, because like he had a friend staying there who would also like hang out, and again, kind of that whole family style, everyone knows each other and whatever. So they made a bunch of sushi, brought that over, and also were like making mojitos. So it was a really nice last night hanging out. Anyways, that was, I think, pretty much where I left off in Pavones. And then next day was all travel, which was Friday. So I left at 6 o'clock in the morning on the first bus, and basically was on the bus until like got into San Jose at 4:20 about, so it was a really long day. That was just the first portion. And then Evan flew into San Jose, so I was waiting for him at the bus station for a few hours. He didn't have cell phone service, so I had no idea what was going on, but assumed like eventually he would get there, and eventually he did. So by the time we left San Jose, it was like we had dinner and then left, I think around 8. So we didn't even get here till after midnight. So it was a really long day. But since then, we've been checking out the area, which has been nice. It's been rainy here way more like the entire trip prior. It's hardly rained at all. So this has been really different. Caribbean side, exact opposite coast of where I was. There's a really big like Rasta reggae influence. A lot of people that came here like originally came from Jamaica, so you get that vibe, which is really cool. So the first day, basically we hung out at this beach called Cocales, which is where we're staying in that area, at this hotel called Le Camaleon, which is really nice. So definitely like different than everywhere prior, more similar to the first week I was here with Hannah and her friend. So staying at a nice place. We hung out at the beach over there, and then later at the hotel, like their beach club restaurant and everything, was having a calypso band play. So that was really cool. We got to check that out, had sushi there. And then the next day was my birthday. So we ended up surfing earlier in Cocles, but it's like a big beach. So this other part of the beach. And it was very different. Definitely not the same as surfing on the other coast. Not as good, but we did catch a few waves, or I caught a few waves surfing by this island over there. So got to do that for a little bit. And then you guys remember I've been having this problem with my ear, it was clogged. So finally I went to the doctor because this guy that was staying in Pavones at the hostel had told me he had the same problem, and he went to this doctor here. So I went. Turns out I did have an ear infection, so it's not like it was just clogged with wax, it was an infection. So he gave me like ear drops and medicine, and I've been taking that ever since, and then staying out of the water. Technically today is the first day I can go back in the water, although I should be using earplugs, which I also got. But with the weather and everything, basically, yeah, like the path, well, anyways. Not happening today. Maybe if it's nicer at some point, hopefully in the next few days, but we're supposed to get a lot more rain. So that was that day, and then walked around the town and like shopped, bought some stuff, which was nice because it's always nice shopping in other countries and getting cool stuff. And then walked along the beach, and later like had a drink at this place called Puerto Pirata, I think. They had a 2-for-1 with this coconut drink. I think it's Coco Loco, which is like coconut water with rum, more or less. And then later we went to this place called Stashu's Fusion, which we heard about. That was supposed to be really good, and it was really good. So for dinner, a lot of like Indian influence and Thai and other stuff. That was really good. That was my birthday. And then afterwards, the next day, again, kind of just exploring different parts. So we went to this area, which is like the very end of the road where it ends, called Manzanillo. There's a refuge park there. So we went in there. There's lots of pretty beaches you can check out, and like trails and stuff. It was super wet though, so we ended up hiking in the mud a lot and just taking our sandals off and like going barefoot. And ended up going down this one trail for a while until we got to this spot where someone along the trail had told us about. There's like a house, and you turn here, it takes you to the beach. So that was kind of the end goal, like let's go there, and then at that point we can head back. So we did that, which was cool to check out something different. There was supposed to be a cave there that we never found, but it was just a pretty park to walk around. So we did that day. And then the next day, I want to say, if I'm keeping track of everything, I think it was yesterday, we ended up doing, we did yoga in the morning. So it's really cool. The hotel offers all these things if you're staying there, part of which is yoga classes, also cooking and cocktail classes we're going to check out tomorrow as well. But we did a yoga class in the morning and then did this tour with this guy called Jungle Man. That's what he goes by, which was cool. So we went to this indigenous village, which is close by, maybe half an hour, called Ribri. And we basically got to see like how they make chocolate, like the old school way. So that was cool, where like you roast the cacao and then you shell it, and like the whole process into grinding up the cacao nibs into like a paste. And then we got to eat it with banana and also drink it like hot chocolate. It was really good. And then there's this guy that was showing us all these different plants and like things you could use it with, all sorts of stuff. It was really cool. Amazing, like how many things come from plants and like what purposes they serve. There was one with different colors that they used to tint stuff. If you can even see, my finger's still a little yellow. You painted it like yellow and another one red, my nail. And then there's like one that was what it produces from this bark or tree. It's like blue. Another one was like rubber, and just all these different plants have different like herbal properties, and just really interesting to learn about, see stuff in their like pure form. And he even showed us, you know, the cord, like the string that comes from this plant, and then they use it to make rope and clothing from this bark, all this sort of stuff. It's really cool. We also got to see, they had a little frog like farm thing there, whatever you call it, which was cool, with some bright red frogs and some like bright neon green and black ones, which are cool. And also this little shaman tent where they'll do these rituals to heal people of their illnesses and stuff like that. So that was really interesting to learn about and explore and see a different, you know, like lifestyle. They're pretty much like the people there are living in really basic huts, like made out of wood and, you know, with the leaves as the roofs and that sort of thing. So it's cool just to see a different side of the town. Very different than the, you know, Rasta vibe, like just right close by. So we did that. And then the rest of the day was pretty chill. Again, it's been raining here a lot, so not necessarily every day is like a day that's nice and sunny you want to spend on the beach all day. So later on, we like hung out around the hotel more, played some pool by the pool, and like checked out the jacuzzi, and like pretty chill rest of the day. Today it's been raining a ton. We had a late start and got brunch at this place called Bread and Chocolate, which was good. It's known for having good chocolate. And anyways, had brunch there, and then we've been checking out some different hostels actually. So there's this one a friend of mine had told me about called Rocking Jays, where everything looks like mosaic style. So it's just different, like a cool place to check out. And you can camp there, so there's all these tents inside that are covered. And all this mosaic type of artwork, just cool. And then now we're at Selena's. So I've been staying at a bunch of the Salinas, you know, along my trip, and I knew they had one here, so I just wanted to see what it looked like. So we've just been hanging out there for a little bit before we probably go back into town and explore a little bit more, walk around town. Stop raining temporarily, but I'm sure that won't last for too long. I think that's everything up until now. Never can be sure, but let me show you a little bit of the view here. I'm on the beach right now, right by the Salina. Yeah, and then I'll say goodbye. All right, check it out. So again, not the prettiest day right now, but still a nice view. Got all these trees hanging over the ocean, the water, little tide pool, rock areas here. So this is what this part of the beach looks like anyways. There's a big rock out there. And then back this way is the Salina, where we're hanging out at right now. So anyways, so that's pretty much everything up until now. I think I'll try to take one last video before I leave. Got a few more days here. And we're both actually heading back on Sunday to San Diego. So trip's coming to an end, but gonna enjoy the last few days before heading back home. Talk to you guys soon. Bye.